I am joined by model, motivational speaker, life coach, and the author of Beautiful Ambition, My Secrets to Love, Happiness, and Success, Tara Brooke. Hi, Tara. How are you today?
I'm great, Brynn. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, thank you for coming on. And what was the inspiration behind wanting to write a tell-all book that helps women feel comfortable in their own skin?
You know, really what motivated me to write this book is that I had such a difficult childhood, and I really wanted to show people that despite all the things that I went through as a kid growing up, you can still overcome and have incredible things happen in your life and have your dreams come true. My parents had gone through a very difficult divorce, as a lot of people, you know, went through in their childhood. My mom was sick at the time, and I had to grow up very quickly. I was 9, in and out of schools, moved around constantly. Very difficult, you know, upbringing. But I had a seed planted early on. I really always wanted to have a better life, and I knew it was up to me. And so throughout my life, I was just able to continue to dive into motivation and change my life for the better. When I finally became successful, I thought, I'm going to write a book. I'm going to tell women everything I think they need to know about to become successful in every area. I'm happily married. I've been married for 14 years. I have twins, 4 years old, a little boy and a little girl, and I'm a co-founder of a nutrition company. So I'm doing a lot of different things, but it's possible for everyone, and that's really the key message behind this book.
Now, how was working in the modeling industry helpful for you in terms of growing and getting past all of those struggles and trials?
You know, it really helped me develop my self-esteem. As I continued to get stronger throughout, you know, my adolescent years, I started to develop my self-esteem. You know, it's one thing, you're never born just with perfect self-esteem. It's like a muscle you have to keep building. Modeling helped me realize that I could do it and that I didn't need to set limits on myself. I could continue to expand. So from that perspective, it did help me quite a bit. It also helped me, you know, navigate and to understanding how people were, how the industry worked, you know, what your purpose is as a model. And it also kind of gave me the idea that I wanted to do other things besides modeling.
Okay, so now what have you found to be some of the most important keys to any of the love, happiness, or success?
The first thing is that you have to want it. You have to have a vision or an idea, a dream. There has to be something on the inside that you say, God, I would really love to go after this. You have to have that first idea of a seed being planted. If you have that, then you can continue to build upon it slowly. Being a positive person is very important. You know, as a young woman, you really need to look at who you're surrounding yourself with, you know, your friends. Do they help you? Do they motivate you? Or do they kind of tear you down or take you away from your goals? Understanding what it is you want to go after is really important. Now, some of us don't know right away. You know, these are things that we learn throughout our life. But I think for most people, there's a talent. There's something that kind of stands out. And those are the things that we kind of tend to move towards. But being able to, you know, dive into motivation and understand that that's what's going to help you get to the next stage and kind of keep going with it, being goal-oriented, writing down what you want, and daydreaming about it. That's really how I got through very difficult times and was able to kind of push through and have a better life. I lived in a daydream of what I wanted my future to be, and I thought about it every single day. And slowly, all of those things were being brought into my life, and my self-esteem was continuing to rise as each thing manifested. And it's a very simple steps you can take, but they're necessary. And those are really the first part of, you know, the thing you need to put in place in the beginning to have those successes.
So did you find it helpful to have that dream goal, like where you wanted to be at the end, or to have goals maybe every 6 months to accomplish?
You know, you have to have a long-term goal and a short-term goal, because just having your long-term goal, if it's far off for you, you know, for example, for me, I was a kid, I had a lot of growing up years, so I would have sub-goals, I'd have smaller goals that I would reach and feel good about, and then I would, you know, go on to the next thing. And you really need to have both the long-term strategy and then the short-term success, so you can celebrate your accomplishments along the way. And that doesn't mean there's not going to be setbacks, because there are, but you can limit them. And really in the book, I show women how they can understand how to build the self-confidence and listen to their gut and trust their instincts. Because we all have that inner voice, and it's just realizing how to listen to it and have it navigate you through all the decisions that you need to make. Because it really is about making the right decisions. And again, we'll all make mistakes, but those right decisions, especially when it comes to relationships, I always tell people that the two most important things are who you marry and who you decide to have children with. And a lot of the people that come to me through my website at TaraBrooke.com are asking relationship questions. And every woman out there I know, and I talk a lot about Mr. Right in this book, they want to find their Prince Charming. And I absolutely believe that there is somebody special for each person. And so I go into that in detail, and I discuss, you know, what men are looking for and all those things. But the book is designed to address every issue that I felt women needed and were looking for.
So now, for those people who maybe a certain circumstance or someone is a bad influence to them, how can they discern if they're in the middle of the situation, not quite don't realize that, if they need to let someone or something go, or if they need to hold on to it?
It's a great question, and really it's relative for everyone. And it's one of those ongoing things. You're always going to have people that come into your life that are there for the right reasons and the wrong reasons. And you can do little simple tests. You know, you can tell people, for example, I just got a promotion at work, and you can see how they respond to that. Are they excited for you, or do they say something negative? Or, you know, there's always that girlfriend that is upset because you lost weight. You know what I mean? Or she tells you, God, that dress doesn't look good on you, when it really does. Those are the kind of things, and they seem kind of funny to talk about, but those little things, they definitely add up, and you want to really align yourself with people that are rooting for you, and in return, you cheer them on as well. So you're getting back this positive reinforcement continually. If you find yourself that you're around people like that, then you need to decide, you know, what does this relationship mean to me, and what am I willing to do? And if it's somebody that has kind of entrenched themselves in your life, then you slowly need to take steps to weed them out. And sometimes it has to be an extreme of changing phone numbers and emails and just doing a total disconnect. But it should always be that you're operating with your friends in a space of, you know, love, and that you're helping each other. You know, women, they don't always have to be competing and pulling each other down. There's such a beautiful relationship that women can have that is fulfilling and builds one another up. And that's what I'm interested in. And that really is what's going to get people all the results they're looking for in their life.
So how is this book set up so that way it can help the everyday woman, whether they're in the exact same shoes you are or their situation might be a 180?
I think it's all about the mindset. You know, you can look at it from wherever situation you're at, whether it was a past situation or a current situation. And I really provide a step-by-step approach on what you need to do. And it all begins with your thinking and then taking the action steps that are laid out in the book. And just putting those into place. And over time, and it's very quick, it happens quick, you'll start to see, wow, this is working for me. This is making me feel good. You know, I'm getting a lot of attention. I've made these changes, and a lot of positive things are happening. And it can just be simple shifts, but you get big rewards very quickly. And it's never too late for people that think, God, you know what, I was married or now I'm divorced, what about me? It's never too late to have your dreams manifest. And I really am speaking for women that really want it all. I mean, most of the people that I come into contact with, they're career-oriented, they've worked hard, you know, they want to have a family, they want to figure out, how do I balance it all? How do I juggle it? And all of those things are laid out in the book. So I'm just very excited to kind of plant those seeds, and I wanted to tell people that if they go to beautifulambition.com, they can get a free chapter of the book. They'll also have the opportunity to get a free sample of the products that I make, and they can enter in to win a contest where I fly somebody out to Newport Beach, and I spend the day with them mentoring them. We go shopping and then have dinner. So it's just a great way for me to connect with the readers and give something back to them on a personal level.
That sounds great. And is that the only place that people can go to purchase a copy of Beautiful Ambition?
No, they can go to Amazon.com. It's also available on Barnes & Noble. But if they want to enter the contest, they would go to Beautiful Ambition, and also if they want to get the sample of the product.
Okay, well, thank you for coming on the program, Tara. It was a pleasure talking with you.
Thank you, Brynn, so much. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. That was Tara Brooke. She is a model, motivational speaker, life coach, and author of the book, Beautiful Ambition.